Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. Just a quick note up front, we may go over our 7 minutes in this episode. The techniques used are more advanced, there's a lot of steps, and I don't want you to get lost. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a graphic novel style animation. You can apply these techniques to any image, but the settings may need to be adjusted depending on the color, brightness, hue, and contrast of your image. There's a lot to go over in this lesson, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's create a new comp, Command N. We're just gonna make this 1920 by 1080, and we'll call this Superhero, and click OK. Now, I grabbed this image from FreePic. It's a subscription-based website where you can download designs and images. The reason why I chose this image is because of the contrast between the subject here and our background. This can be easily rotoed out using the After Effects Roto Brush. Just keep in mind that depending on your image, there's not a lot of contrast between your subject in the background, and you want to do it the way I'm doing it, you may need to mask this character out using your pen tool. So let's just drag this in. And now if you double click on it, it now brings you over to Layer Superhero instead of Composition Superhero. And now we can choose this Roto Brush tool here. Holding down your left mouse button, just kind of draw a line through all of this. And then you'll see this pink that goes around things. And as you can see, we didn't grab everything. So you need to kind of do this in a few steps. Say if you want to get rid of this area right here, you simply hold down the Option button and your green circle becomes red with a line through it. And this does the opposite. So you want to scrub through the areas that you don't want. Increase your feather to about maybe 20. Take a look and see how this is looking. So if you go back to your composition for Superhero, and then let's just resize him so he fits. If you hit your apostrophe button, it brings up your guides, and I like to center my character, so see how his head is right here in the middle. With this layer highlighted, Command-Shift-C to pre-compose, and we'll call this Image, and you want to move all attributes into a new composition. Click OK. Now let's just right-click, choose Time, and hit Freeze Frame. And the reason why you want to do that is because as you scrub through this image that we applied the Roto Brush to, at some point the Roto Brush effect will fall off, and your background will pop back up. And so see, we're just using this as a still image. So that's why you want to freeze frame. Now let's just shorten this down to 6 seconds. And the way you do that is bring your playhead to the 6 second mark, hit N, and it pulls your handles over. Right click on this bar and choose trim comp to work area. So now our total animation is only 6 seconds long. Add a new solid. This is gonna be our background. And you can make this any color you want. I'm gonna add a gradient. You can also add any image you want behind them. I'm just gonna do a really quick radial ramp. Okay, so let's go ahead and lock down that background layer. Right click in this area, choose new shape layer, and we are going to create an ellipse, and we need to add a fill and a stroke. Now let's just increase this ellipse so it covers our character other than his head and his hands, and go ahead and pull this underneath our image here. Let's make this fill blue and make your stroke red, and now let's increase this stroke width so we have something kind of like that. I want to put this character inside of the circle, but I want things like his cape to still be on the outside and his hands and his head. Decrease this stroke a little bit so we can kind of see his head a little bit. First, let's rename this shape layer circle background. Command D to duplicate it, bring it to the top, and rename this circle mat. And let's open up our circle mat, and let's go ahead and get rid of our stroke. And then for our image layer, let's change the track mat to alpha mat. And you see it doesn't fit perfectly inside of the stroke. And the reason why is because our stroke is on top of our fill. So let's bring that stroke underneath our fill. But we still need the top part of him, like his cape and his hands and his head, to be on the outside of the circle. So let's grab this image layer, Command D to duplicate it. It'll move it to the top because you have it on alpha mat. Let's just move that underneath the other image layer. And we're going to change that track mat back to no track mat. G to bring up your pen tool. And you want to include everything other than the lower part of his body. So let's just kind of draw a quick mask around him. And so now our character should fit inside of our circle there. Toggle mask visibility off. And so now our character fits inside. Looks like we still need to clean up a little bit. Right click, new shape layer. And let's rename this text box. And we're going to add a group. And inside of that group, we're going to add a rectangle and a fill. And we're going to change that fill to white. So let's just move this text box, your rectangle path, and you want to adjust your size and maybe put some roundness on it. Grab the circle mat, the first image layer, and the circle background and parent that to the second image. Now, whenever you adjust the size of this image, everything follows it. So let's increase this a little bit. And now we're going to add another group. Let's add a path, and it will automatically turn on your pen tool. So we want this to create like a little triangle shape. Then let's add a fill and make that fill white. So with contents highlighted, add a stroke, and see it goes to the bottom of our layers here, and let's change that to black and then increase the size to maybe 6. It adds a stroke around the entire text box area. Okay, so now let's move our text box underneath both images. It's behind his hand there, and Command T to create some text. I can fly. I have this really cool comic book font, and I will include that along with the project file in the notes, and also remove this text on top of our text box, also below the images. So that way, if fingers kind of go over it like that. And let's parent our text layer to our text box. So now the text box highlighted, click Y to bring up your pan around tool. And you want to bring your anchor point down to the corner. Text box highlighted, click S to bring up scale. And let's put a keyframe there. Shift page down to go forward 10 frames. Another keyframe. And again, shift page down to go forward another 10 frames. And a keyframe there. We want this to bounce in. So we need our second keyframe to be about 115. So it kind of bounces up a little bit. And we want our first keyframe to be 0. So highlight these. And if you right click keyframe assistant, and also use F9 as a shortcut. And then let's highlight this middle keyframe, bring up our graph editor, and pull these handles away from it. So that way it kind of bounces in and it hangs just a little bit. Okay, and I'm going to make just a few adjustments because I'm not crazy about the way this text box is looking. So now let's just parent this text box to our image on layer 3 here. Right click, new shape layer, and let's bring it right above our background layer. Add an ellipse and add a fill. And let's make that fill something dark. P for position, and let's just make both of these values 0, so it should be in our top left corner. Okay, and let's go ahead and rename this dots. For our ellipse path, let's make this size 5, and then we're going to add a repeater, and it automatically brings up 3 copies. So we're going to change this to 150, and we need to offset this differently. So right now, all of these dots are separated by 100 pixels. We want them to be a lot closer than that. So let's make it something more like 15. So let's highlight contents again and click repeater one more time. So we're basically going to repeat the repeater. And this time we're going to add again 150 copies. But for our transform properties in our repeater 2, we want to make this 0. And now we want to make the Y value 15. And so now we have our dots behind our guy. So basically, if you look at our repeaters, the X value on the position of repeater 1 is 15, 0, and on repeater 2, it's 0, 15. So that's how we got the same exact distance, both horizontally and vertically. And now you can change the size of your ellipse path if you want. So if you make it a little bit bigger, you can do that. I kind of like it a little bit smaller, so I'll go back to 5. Okay, so now let's grab all the layers from circle background up to circle matte, right-click, and choose pre-compose, and we'll call this image pre-comp. The right-click, new, shape layer, let's add a group. I'm going to add a rectangle with a fill and a stroke. And now let's make this fill maybe a little bit darker red. And then we want our stroke to be even darker still. Let's open up our rectangle path properties and unlock your size. Stretch this out and maybe make this about 75%. R for rotation. And let's rotate this negative 30 degrees. So maybe make this stroke a little bit darker. Let's duplicate this group 1. If you use our transform properties for group 2. You can just move this stripe up and down. And now let's duplicate the red stripe layer and call this blue stripes. And we'll do basically the same thing. Let's click blue. And as long as this layer is highlighted, it will change all of your settings. Grab that blue, but make it a little bit darker. And now, of course, we want to offset these from our red stripe. So let's open up our contents, group 2, transform properties. And then let's grab our group 1 transform properties. Move this one down. And we'll make this one thinner. Let's put a P for position here. For group 2 on our blue stripe, and for group 1, hold down shift, page down twice, another keyframe. Let's go back to our first keyframe here, and then let's just change our x-axis to negative 2250, so that way it's just right off screen, and our bottom one also to negative 2250. And we're going to do the same thing for our red stripes. So let's open up our transform properties on our red stripes and put a keyframe for position for group 2, as well as group 1, shift, page down twice. And let's just go ahead and repeat that keyframe. Go back to the first one. And on our x-axis for group 2, negative 2250. And for position x-axis for group 1, negative 2250. So highlight these last two keyframes, right-click, ease in, or you can use a shortcut for that. And same thing for our blue stripes. If you highlight the layer and click U, right-click, keyframe assistant, ease in. Let's highlight all these keyframes here and open up our graph editor. And we just want to pull this handle as far left as you can. So that way they come in fast and then come to a slow stop. Pull this second set over 2-3 keyframes And the same thing for our red stripes, and maybe offset this layer a little bit. Maybe we'll have his text come in at about 10 frames. So we go back into our image pre-comp here. If you highlight both of those and hit your left bracket, it will pull the layers to where your playhead is. Let's create a new solid. Let's make it white, and we're gonna call this cloud. And let's take our pen tool and just draw kind of a basic cloud shape. It doesn't have to be anything amazing or great, just something that kind of is going to resemble a cloud. Okay, so now we're going to go to Effect, Obsolete Fast Blur. Just add a blur of about 100. Let's uncheck our mask visibility here. As for scale, and unlock our X and Y axis, crank up the X axis here a little bit. And we're going to put this cloud below our guy and kind of move him over a little bit. Click T for opacity and bring this down to about 75%. We're going to duplicate that cloud layer and bring it on top of our image comp. And let's just move it on top of our guy, but at the bottom. So now with both cloud layers highlighted, bring up your position, so P. And then let's go to our 6 second frame, so the end of our comp way down here. We're gonna move that left so it animates this way. And then the top, we're gonna animate to the right. So let's go into our image comp. Let's just Command T to bring up text. Click in here and let's just type in S, because he's Superman. And kind of resize this a little bit, right around his tie. Change your track mode to overlay. It looks like it's more like it's ironed on to his shirt there. Then we want it to be underneath this tie. So click G for your pen tool. Let's go ahead and just mask around his tie here. Yeah, you can either choose subtract and it will do the trick, or if you are on add, you can just hit invert. And click F to bring up the feathering and maybe add about a 5 pixel blur on that. Now see, we have this hole right here, so we must have missed that. Let's go back into the image layer, and sure enough, we do. So let's double click our superhero image, and there we go. Now it's closed off. Okay, so let's go back out to our main comp here. I'm gonna kind of readjust the size of our image comp. So let's maybe increase this a little bit. So with our image pre-comp highlighted, let's go to Effect, Stylize, and add Cartoon Filter. These settings will need to be adjusted based on how your image looks. The settings are very, very sensitive. So Detail Radius, 15, Threshold, 35. Shading Steps, I'm gonna change that to 10. Shading Smoothness, change that to 20. Threshold here, we want to make this 1.6 is fine. Width, we can make that 2. For Edge Softness, you want to bring it down all the way to 0. So that's basically our graphic novel look there. Let's go to our image pre-comp. And just to kind of give it some depth, we want to add Drop Shadow. So Perspective, Drop Shadow. Our Distance, let's make it 60. Softness, 60. So highlight the Drop Shadow, Command-C to copy. And then let's bring in our stripes here and Command V to paste them. It'll kind of give them some depth. That's a little bit too far for our stripe. So let's kind of bring this in a little bit. Maybe make that 20, make this say 40. And the same thing for our red stripes. Make our distance 20, our softness 40. Let's highlight dots and we're gonna choose the ellipse tool. Since this is a shape layer, you'll see that you have two options. You have this star here, which is a tool creates a shape, or this tool creates a mask. We wanna create a mask, so make sure you click that on. Start to draw your circle and then hold down shift and it'll make a perfect circle. And then let's kind of just adjust where this is located. F on our dots layer to bring up feathering, and let's feather this out at maybe 150 pixels. If you hit MM with the layer that has a mask, it brings up all of your mask properties. So let's just kind of expand this a little bit. So that way we see more of the dots, but it's just not taking up the entire background. And then we can bring back up our mask visibility and kind of tweak with these things a little bit so it's not exactly a perfect circle. But we can kind of see more of the dots. Maybe increase this to 100. So that way we see more of the dots. Okay, so now with image pre-comp selected, let's scale this down a little bit. It's a little big. On position, we're going to add an expression. So hold down option and click position and just type wiggle 2.6 to kind of give our guy a little bit of movement. And that's how you make a graphic novel scene out of an image using shape layers and a background and some basic text. I'm including the project file and notes in a Dropbox link in the description below. Please like, share, and subscribe. Leave your comments and let me know if there's something you'd like to see. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.